Welcome to a Canvas Conversation with the Conway League of Artists. I'm Penny Hatfield from the University of Central Arkansas's Outreach and Community Engagement. We're going to start our conversation with Karen Freeman, who is the president of the Conway League of Artists. Welcome, Karen.
Thank you.
Tell us a little bit about the Conway League of Artists.
The Conway League of Artists has been here for about 50 years. We still have some of the founding members, and we meet once a month on the second Tuesday evening at the Faulkner County Library. We try to give opportunities for the artists in the area to show their work, maybe sell their work. So we work with Art Walk downtown and UCA and give them opportunities. We have a scholarship fund that we give to a young UCA student. Art student each year, and we have programs and workshops and mentor programs, so we try to fill in all the holes.
It sounds like you do. So one of the things that I notice, I see work by the Conway League of Artists at the library, mm-hmm. or maybe I've seen it at what used to be AMC downtown.
Right.
Most of that has been paintings, but I think you probably have artists that work in other mediums as well. Is that correct?
We do. We try to open it up to everybody. So we have collage artists, and we have, we have artists in different mediums like pastel and the charcoal, and we also have woodworkers.
Okay.
We have a father and son who do beautiful woodwork, and we're open to everybody, so we're looking for people in different mediums. Yeah.
And you're a potter, is that correct?
I'm a painter and a potter.
A painter and
yes.
a potter,
mm-hmm.
okay.
Mm-hmm.
Is it hard to decide what you want to work on?
Yes, it's so funny, it depends on the weather maybe. If it's a sunny day and the light's good, I'll do painting.
Okay.
If not, I'll go up and do some pottery.
Okay.
Yeah.
What, do you like one or the other better?
Oh, I couldn't tell you that.
Okay.
No.
Okay.
I don't know.
But for both of those, do you go in or do you sketch out an idea about what you want to do and then try to recreate it? Or how does one start?
I do, well, for painting, I do a preliminary sketch.
Okay.
I sure do. I work from photographs, you know, that
okay.
I've taken, you know, in different places. In pottery, you have an idea about what shape you're going to go for. You don't do any mm-hmm. preliminary sketches or anything, but then you go for it, and sometimes the clay tells you what it wants to
okay.
be. So
okay.
Yeah.
Is most of your pottery utilitarian, or is it, you know, just for home decor things?
About half and
just,
half.
But...
Yeah, half and half. I do a lot of bowls and
uh-huh.
and things like that, but I also do a different kind of pottery for just art's sake.
Okay.
Just because it's a fun shape or
uh-huh.
texture.
Mm-hmm. And what about, is there anything that you will incorporate in the clay?
I am doing some horsehair pottery right now. So
okay.
I take some white clay and burn horsetail pieces in it, and it curls and makes a beautiful black mark on the white clay. And it's real fun.
How did you start doing something like that?
I saw some out in the West, in the Southwest, and I just thought that would be really great to try.
Oh, wow, I'll bet it is.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Is it hard to find the horsehair?
I've got six horses in my neighborhood
okay.
who have donated their pieces of their tails. I'm almost out, so I've got to go and ask for some more soon.
Well, you're living in the right neighborhood.
I am, perfect, perfect.
That's great.
Yeah.
That's great. So this exhibit is going to feature several different artists, is that correct?
Yes. We'll have as many as five working back in the UCA downtown gallery. And then the show will have maybe 25 painters who put their work here too.
And will that be available for sale?
Yes, absolutely. Almost all of it will probably be for sale.
Okay, great.
Sure.
So for those of you who don't know, the art will be on exhibit from November 16th until December 16th here at UCA downtown on Oak Street. The gallery hours are Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday from noon to 5 p.m. But in addition to that, on November 13th, which is the downtown Christmas open house, we will have some folks from the Conway League of Artists mm-hmm. here from, I think it's 1 to 4 p.m. And their wares will be for sale as well,
They will have some watercolorists and some oil painters and all kinds of different mediums for sale.
And you know, those are such great Christmas presents. I mean, we all get so much stuff that we can't use or we maybe re-gift. not that I would know anything about that.
No.
Or that we give away to somebody else. And these pieces are so wonderful.
They are, because they're made from your neighbors and your
friends
right here in your own community. And I love to see people, when I walk into somebody's home, to see some original art there.
And they're unique. That's exactly what I was going to say. They're unique. They're original. It's not something that somebody else can go down to a big box store and purchase and have one exactly like it
Absolutely.
In their home.
Absolutely. Unique.
You have a piece that is unique to you.
That's right. We really, really love some of the area stores who are letting us put our unique individual art in their stores, and we appreciate that very much.
One of the things that I really appreciate about Conway is I feel like the local folks really support one another, whether it's the bakers or the clothes salespeople or the artists, and I think that's great that happens. One other thing, and you mentioned this, but you also participate in the Art Walk, which will be December 2nd, and it will be from 5 to 8 p.m. Again, Art will be here from the Conway League of Artists at UCA downtown.
Right. We're looking forward to that. We'll have quite a few artists here, and I sold some art in the last one was it just last Friday night?
Yeah, I was gonna say.
And had a great time meeting people and meeting other artists and selling some pottery.
And Art Walk is great. Even if you don't buy anything, it's fun to get out to see the art that's in Conway, and again, shop locally. We do have another visitor from the Conway League of Artists, who is Sterling Morton. And tell me about the art that you do, Sterling.
I do mostly woodworking, but I integrate ceramics and I integrate stained glass and leather. And just, you know, oddly, sometimes rocks.
So you told me a story earlier that I'd really like for you to repeat about how you got started with this.
Oh, yeah. I started, when I was a kid. And I built little wooden airplanes out of 2x4s and whatever was available on my grandfather's circular saw and whatever hand tools were available. And so I went to college and graduate school, and after that I had an opportunity to get back into it, mainly because I needed some certain piece, so I would machine out a piece and I had access to a mill, and so it just slowly evolved back into woodworking again. And trying to get that worm that's in your head that needs to be creative out into a tangible piece.
So when you got back into it, did you realize how much you'd missed it?
I did.
Did you?
I did.
And wondered why maybe you hadn't started sooner?
Yeah, that's right. That's right.
Do you sell most of your pieces? What do you do with your work?
Oddly enough, a lot of it gets given away. Somebody will have a birthday we had a wedding in the family, and so that and piece ended up, and I built cabinets for relatives that live in Texas, and so a lot of it gets given away. I try to sell what I can.
But, you know, as Karen and I were talking earlier, those gifts are so wonderful because they're unique and they mean something because you made them.
Yeah.
And so that means something to that couple that has that wedding gift for you, or someone who has a birthday gift or whatever.
That's
so
right.
That is so wonderful.
And also, when it's a bespoke piece, you can add things to it. Like one of the things that I like adding in pieces is a trifoil window with a gilt cross inside the trifoil window. And you're not going to get that at IKEA.
No.
Excuse me. You're not going to get that there.
But, no.
So that's you can add things like that mean a lot to the person that's receiving the gift.
Absolutely. Absolutely. How long have you been involved with the Conway League of Artists?
Oddly enough, COVID kind of shut everything down for a couple of years. So about a year before that and up to now.
What brought you to
years.
Them?
My mother belonged to the Conway League of Artists way back then. She's an oil painter.
Okay.
And so I've always known about them. And this was my opportunity to meet other artists and to talk and have camaraderie and friendship. And there you are.
It's kind of a way to get to talk about ideas
what
works and sometimes what doesn't.
Well, I learned from Karen automatically, how to take a form, a cylindrical form. And that's kind of one of the things that I'd like to get into is some wheel throwing. And integrate wheel throwing into wood. And one of the pieces that I made is you know, you think of a box, you know, a lot of things that I make are wooden boxes. Well, you can turn a wooden box into a cylindrical form, and it kind of becomes abstractly a box. But if you integrated a ceramic form into a wooden form, and when I saw her horsehair piece, I immediately mm-hmm. saw wood surrounding the mm-hmm. horsehair piece. Yeah, that wow. would be cool.
Okay, what about your mother's painting? Has that influenced you?
Absolutely. I mean, how can you not have parents that have a very creative side? My father's an engineer, and my mother is okay. more or less a housewife. And, you know, to have that artistic influence when you're growing up and being able to go to the theater and see galleries when mm. you're growing up, I think very much improves, you know, your lifestyle, both growing up and as an adult.
So. Yeah, and it just widens your horizon.
It does. Yeah, so it's important.
Absolutely. All right, so are you going to be having some pieces in the upcoming show?
I would like to find some way to do it. I have some ceramic pieces that I'll try to put in. Yeah, I'll have to get the kiln warmed up.
You can do that. You can do that. You can warm up that kiln, no yeah. problem. You can warm that up, yeah. Yeah, that would be fun to do that.
I think so.
And it would be, I love the idea of incorporating wood and ceramics, and I'm looking forward to seeing how you do that.
A lot of woodworkers see only one media that they can use. Mm-hmm. And to add glass to wood elevates both the wood and the glass.
Yeah, absolutely. So where do you get your wood?
It's a supplier in Little Rock called okay. Lestine.
Okay, okay.
That's mainly where I get it. A lot of times I'll be able to get wood because somebody has cut a tree down.
Okay.
And if I hear of anybody that has black walnut, I will jump on that. Because it's not easy to get. You know, it's abundant, but it's not easy to get.
Yeah.
They don't have it at Lowe's.
That's true. Well, I know. That's the reason I'm thinking, where do you get it? They don't have it at Lowe's. So where does one get it?
Great. One of the pieces, well, we received a load of walnut from a local sawyer. And he took the prime pieces out, and I got the pieces that have the knot holes and that kind of mm-hmm. thing. But that's fine because, you know, you can work with the knots or you can cut the knots out.
Okay.
And right now I'm working on a piece that there was a knot that led to a crack. But that crack has, and the wood surrounding the crack has what I call them are fairies, but it's the undulation of the wood creates ripples and I can't even really describe how it looks. It's an astonishing visual. Mm-hmm. And what I do is book match, which means you cut the piece of wood in half and then okay. lay it like that, and what you have are two mirrored pieces. Mm-hmm. So if there's a lot of figure in this, it'll immediately go into that piece.
Sure.
And when they're perfectly joined, you can't really see where the joint is.
Oh, wow.
And so you have this display, this magnificent firework of wood.
Wow.
And to put that into a piece is really special.
It just really enhances the character of it.
It does, yeah. Oh, that's exactly it. It's character.
You know, that oh wow, that's fascinating. I'd love to see that.
But it's one of the things how you treat the crack.
Mm-hmm.
That's one of the things that experience gives you is your ability to take what is a disaster and work with it and turn it into a feature.
All flaws are not necessarily flaws. They're sometimes a feature.
A feature.
If you can turn them into that. Well, that's great. Thank you so much.
Sure, thank you.
Thank you for joining us for a Canvas Conversation with the Conway League of Artists. We hope that you will join us at UCA Downtown to see their work. It will be on exhibit from November 16th through December 16th. November 13th will be the Conway Downtown Christmas Open House. We will be open from 1 to 4 p.m. And of course, we've got the December Art Walk, the first Friday in December. We look forward to seeing you at UCA Downtown and enjoy the Conway League of Artists exhibit.